Hey, everybody. We're going to get started in about 5 minutes, so if everybody could make it to their seats. We don't think it's going to get any better than this, so let's get it going. Okay, everybody, have your seats. We're going to get started in just a second. Thank you.
Q.
Luann. Kooks. Bell.
Corey.
John.
And I'm Link.
Dark when you feel lost. Wanna be the best, but at what cost? If you're gonna stay here, nothing's ever changing. No big world, gotta see it all. Gotta get up even when you fall. There's no point in waiting.
Yeah.
last night. So watch me bring the fire, set the night light. My shoes on, get up in the morning, cup of milk, let's rock and roll. Kink out, kick the drum, rolling on like a Rolling Stone. Sing song when I'm walking home, jump up to the top of LeBron. Ding dong, call me on my phone, nice tea and I'll get my ping pong.
This is dead heavy, can't hear the bass boom, I'm ready.
I'm going to college.
Okay, you ready?
Yeah.
I'm going to college.
I am going to college. Yo voy a ir al colegio.
I'm going to college.
We're going to college.
I'm smiling. I'm going to college.
I'm going to college.
Voy al colegio.
I'm going to college.
Going to college.
I'm going to college.
I'm going to college.
We're going to college.
Bring it. I don't want to get wet. Okay. Good afternoon. Buenas tardes. Today's Pentecost Sunday, and if the outpouring of the Spirit is as abundant as this rain, we are truly blessed today. Let us pray. On this Pentecost Sunday, we raise our voices to you, Spirit of God. Divine breath of life, truth, and love, source of all our gifts and talents. Come, Holy Spirit, and renew the face of the earth. Continue the work of love that you have begun on these young men and women, our Cristo Rey Jesuit class of 2021. Instill in them a spirit of joy and gratitude for the gifts that you have bestowed on them and for the love they have received in their lives, from family, friends, and from us here at Cristo Rey Jesuit. As our graduates move on to college and beyond, confirm in them their appreciation for the fact that they're alive and their thirst for continued learning and growth. Be their rest and comfort when they grow weary. Be their consolation when tears overwhelm them. Be their strength when their lives are feeble. Be their light when doubts confuse them. Be their hope when despair reigns in their hearts. Come, Holy Spirit, and be with us as we celebrate today. Bring joy to the relatives of our graduates and to the hearts of our faculty, staff, and board members. For it is by your inspiration that we offer who we are and what we do in the service of God's mission. May we always rejoice in your presence, and may we always bear faithful witness of God's mercy and love. Amen.
I had this whole speech about how much fortitude this class has, and here we are in a pouring rain, so kind of indicative of the entire year. But I welcome you, class of 2021, and all your parents, guardians, family members, and friends, as well as our board of trustees and our faculty and staff to the 9th Cristo Rey Jesuit Commencement Exercises. And welcome everybody at home watching on the live stream ceremony. Thank all of you for attending and watching. What an honor it is to stand before these amazing young men and women, this very special class of 2021. This is the 9th graduation commencement of our school's young history, and certainly will be one of the most memorable. We have so much to celebrate with this class of 2021. And again, for the second year in a row, we come together on this field. We also want to thank Father Jeff Johnson, the president of Strake Jesuit, and one of our Cristo Rey Jesuit Board of Trustee members, and all the Strake Jesuit staff for helping us make this happen. Thank you, Father Johnson. Now, I have to apologize up front because I'm sure you're all tired of hearing about the pandemic and COVID-19 and how difficult this year has been. I know everybody's ready to get back to normal and on with your lives. But I have to bring it up because we need to acknowledge what this class of 2021 has accomplished in the face of adversity that no Cristo Rey Jesuit senior class has faced during their entire senior year. It's equally important to know that overcoming the pandemic does not define this class of 2021, but it's allowed them to show off their fortitude and grit in the most explicit ways. We all know that you have an abundance of resilience in your personal lives. After all, you just completed a 4-year rigorous college prep curriculum, going to class only 4 days a week, and some weeks you only went 3. And the day that you weren't on campus, you were working in a professional office, earning half the cost of your education. That, my friends, is the definition of grit, and that is why these young men and women And that is what these young men and women have done for the past 4 years. So then along comes COVID-19 and a worldwide pandemic to throw a huge roadblock in your entire senior year. What did all of you do? You stepped up and you did your work and you learned and you loved and you cared for each other and you cared for your families and your Cristo Rey Jesuit family. You truly are a very special graduating class. And all the faculty and the staff here at Cristo Rey Jesuit feel so blessed that you were here at this time. You turned what was stacking up to be a very difficult year into something wonderful. Something that we were able to grow through. So thank you, seniors, for leading the way. Seniors, your parents and guardians have been the constant in your lives. The foundation of Jesuit education lies in the partnership between the students, parents, and guardians, and the faculty and staff of the school. Parents and guardians, we are so appreciative to you for trusting us with your child's education and providing them with the support necessary to earn the degree that they will receive today. You should be proud of this great accomplishment. Thank you. Padres y tutores deben estar orgullosos de este gran logro. Gracias. Our thanks go out to our corporate partners, many of them watching on today's live stream. You welcomed our students into your places of business for three of the past 4 years, and you, along with numerous independent mentors, gave your valuable time to work with them directly in spite of the restrictions of the pandemic this past year. You embraced them, you mentored them, you taught them, and you loved them. Thank you for being a critical part of the success that we celebrate today. Because of you, our students experienced a transformation few high school students in this country get to experience. So thank you very much. I would like to ask all of our faculty and staff to please stand. You have spent more time with these young men and women than anybody in the last 4 years, and your influence will forever be part of their minds and their souls. You've experienced the highs and the lows, and you prepared them academically and spiritually to be men and women for others. And this year you learned to master online teaching, hybrid lessons, synchronous, asynchronous, the list goes on. You came through this year in ways that are simply amazing, and we thank you. Thank you for your commitment to the formation of these seniors. Seniors, I want you to think back 4 years ago when you were freshmen entering the gymnasium that first time in those tunnel of bam-bams. Seems like yesterday, doesn't it? This day, today, right now, was probably the last thing on your mind then. But think about it. Think about what you've accomplished, all the hard work, all the drama, all the celebrations and the happiness that you've experienced. You have earned a college preparatory degree with distinction, and you've been taught the values of Jesuit education, to be open to growth, committed to justice, loving, religious, intellectually distinguished, and work experienced. No matter what you end up doing with your lives or how you define success for yourself, always remember that we are all called to be men and women for others, for the greater glory of God. And Mr. Paul Steyer, our Board of Chairman, parents and guardians, family and friends of our graduates, and to our corporate work study partners, our benefactors, and our supporters. On behalf of the trustees and the faculty and staff, and as president of Cristo Rey Jesuit College Preparatory School of Houston, I officially open the 9th commencement exercises and welcome the graduating class of the school, the senior class of 2021. Let's give these young men and women a thunderous applause. Now I'd like to welcome Aileen Quinones, our Director of Academics and the Principal of Cristo Rey Jesuit, to the podium to introduce our student speakers.
It is truly an honor to introduce our first student graduation speaker, Nevin Din. Nevin has served as student council president for this school year. He is active in track and field and theater with a YouTube. He is a prestigious Posse scholar and will attend the University of Virginia on a full scholarship. Please welcome Nevin Din.
Is this thing on? Alrighty. Good afternoon, board members, Mr. Paul Beck, president of Cristo Rey Jesuit, leadership, faculty, staff, corporate work studies program sponsors, live at home, parents, family members, and my class of 2021. I know what you're thinking. Why Nevin again? He's student body president, Mr. CRJ, just crowned prom king. By the way, congratulations, Jacob. Has been all over the school's social media page, especially Facebook and TikTok. And now I'm here. I could even ask Ms. Morrison to be my agent. Can you be my agent, please? Well, here's my answer to it. Oops, I did it again. You can all laugh. <Funny. laughs> Back in 2017, we were all applying for high school. And here we are, 4 years later, together one last time for our graduation. Why the static? We have gone. Is it on now? Okay. Technical issues. More technical issues again. It's okay. It's a memorable one, okay? This is a memorable graduation. Technical difficulties, I'm sorry. We have gone through a grueling and complex college application process, including writing essays and completing the financial aid forms. Hi, college counselors. And by now, we are committed to colleges across the country. Some members of our class will stay in Texas. Others are going to the East Coast. I am, for one, going to Virginia. Before coming to Cristo Rey, I was sometimes introvert, but also an extrovert. I walked into campus on the first day knowing only four people because they went to my middle school. Hi to the four. Let's just say that my confidence level back then was below average. Raise your hands if you ever felt that, like, felt low confidence level in freshman year. Everyone raise their hands if they felt that. Only a few, really? Okay. But by now, here I am, honored to have been chosen to speak to all of you, more confident than ever, happy with the person I am today. Not only have I been able to build on the best version of myself, but I also gained 132 classmates, developed relationships with teachers that I have the pleasure to be in their classrooms, and the whole Cristo Rey Jesuit community that I get to call my second family. Stepping into Cristo Rey Jesuit, staff and teachers made me feel welcome the second I walked through the hallways. I immediately felt part of a community that I can call now my second family. Since the beginning, I have felt a sense of happiness, knowing that the journey ahead will continue to be a roller coaster full of accomplishments and challenges. To be clear, I have dealt with a lot of ups and downs during high school, like many of you. During these 4 years, you have gotten to know each other, learning, understanding, and having fun. There are times with my fellow classmates where we just want to act like goofballs, and also there are times where we need to have a shoulder to lean on. There are times when we fall out, well, because we're human beings. Especially this year when everyone has dealt with the most unexpected situations, including this one right now. But we are an amazing class that supports one another, and also teachers and staff that have been helping us all to succeed academically and evolve spiritually. I think of high school as a TV show, basically. Every year is a new season, and every day is a new episode. Close your eyes and think for a moment. How is your high school experience similar to your show preferences? I'll give y'all 5 seconds. Some might say that these 4 years have been like Miraculous Ladybug, The Vampire Diaries, My Hero Academia, The Office, Naruto, and many more. Either way, I think all these shows have something in common. Every day or every episode, there will be something new or a new plot. The same characters that we got to see every day make funny jokes or become the protagonist, antagonist. What makes it unique is that it fills our high school experience with lots of memories that we can hold on to. Just like we remember a specific quote from a TV show, especially knowing the exact episode and season, it is something that we can always look back on. Even though we're all worried about the rain, please allow me to share a little bit about me and my background and allow yourself to relate to my own story. I am a first generation Vietnamese American. My families were refugees from Vietnam escaping communism. They all started over from scratch, building things up in a brand new country. When I was a child, I had speech impediment. My first words came out when I was 3 years old. Doctors said that I can only speak one language at that time because of my condition. I didn't know anything around me, not even knowing what was going on. All I can remember was seeing my parents cry, not knowing what would happen to me. My condition and the amount of work they went through to live their American dream put a lot of pressure on them. I have witnessed them work hard day and night so that both me and my brother can survive. They sacrificed everything for both of us. just like many of your parents and grandparents have done for you. Even when I was bullied back when I used to go to public school, my parents did everything they could to make me happy. For middle school, they enrolled me into a Catholic school, which was better than public school for me. Still, they made enormous sacrifices and dedicated their time to be here to give both me and my brother a better life. Like many of you, I feel like we need to take initiative not only for ourselves, but for our parents, grandparents, and extended families so that we can live a better future. Therefore, I had developed a mindset to be more open, to be more determined, and to be more of myself so that I can achieve everything and anything in life. All I have always hoped for is to make my parents proud and to see how they have raised two young men in front of them to be more resilient and stronger than ever. From being a failing student in elementary school to being the student council president and standing in front of you all today en route to one of the most prestigious colleges in the country shows that with hard work and mentors, we can reach our goals. With faith in God that things will always go in His almighty name, and hard work, all things will become reality for His greater glory. Indeed, I am living that American dream. We all are. All these 4 years, we have gained a lot of moral values, especially the graduation values. Especially during this pandemic, I got a more clear perspective on these values. Let's be honest, I sometimes have trouble finding those values in my daily life. But as I reflected, it doesn't have to be big. We are work experience when we helped and contributed to our corporate work study sponsors. We are open to growth and intellectually distinguished when we engage in Socratic seminars, learning from different perspectives. We are all committed to justice when we pray and prepare to contribute to change in the midst of so much negativity in society, especially what's going on right now. African American communities and Asian and Pacific Islander communities are attacked with racism and xenophobia. Women's rights taken away from those sexism and misogyny, and LGBTQ being discriminated against based on who they love and who they want to be, and voting rights endangered in many places are just a few examples of many injustices that we see in society and our communities every day. We are loving and religious because we love God and each other for who we are. We have not only seen these values, but we live them every day. I have seen these values in the teachers and staff, my fellow classmates, and most importantly, my family. Through my life, I have learned how to be a faithful human being through the support of my family, which is my rock. Even before we started high school, we are all living it piece by piece with joy. I have learned to be myself, to be more confident in what I believe in, and also to be a warrior, to fight for justice and to not only pray for each other, but to work with our talents to be men and women for each other and to bring more joy into this world. Lastly, please allow me to remind us all of Father Torres's homily as we are ready to move on in the less sheltered stage in our life. Pray for each other and every one of us to be confident than ever. Every challenge and blessing comes from God, our Heavenly Father. We just need to pray that in His will, let it be done. Prepare for what is up ahead of us. Let's be prepared not only for future pandemics, God forbid, but also challenges along the way. In college, our future careers, with our families, questions about our faith, anything, etc. Let's just be prepared for what is to come ahead in our path. Lastly, if you remember Father Torres's words, practice. Practice what we prayed for. Practice what we have learned in our lifetime and during 4 years here in Christ Ray Jesuit. Practice what we can do to be game changers, agents of change, and social justice. Our generation can and will do many things. We can build each other up, and we can make social change in our world for a positive and happy world. To sum this all up, we need to reflect and discern to determine what is right. God wants us to do good for mankind, and with His guidance, we are able to do so. Let us continue to allow God to enter into our hearts so that we can become His catalyst for change. Even though this pandemic has been tough for all of us, we are here. We made it. Think of this as a test to show how strong and determined each one of us are to going through the obstacles. We should all be proud for who we are and what we have achieved throughout high school. My message for all of us is to for great things, to do good for the world, and to never back down, even when it's hard. Follow the conscience God has given us. Make decisions that we will never forget. To my family, especially my mom, my dad, my grandparents, and my extended family in Vietnam, who is watching this live stream at 2 o'clock in the morning right now. Thank you so much. I love y'all with my heart.
I thank God for giving me this family that I will always be part of. Thank you again for sacrificing everything for me. Come on, meba, baba wai wai. Go yêu gia đình, với tất cả trái tim của con. To the teachers that have taught me or have waved hi to me in the hallways, I want to thank you for your dedication, for your generosity. You have helped me and my classmates to excel in academics and also in life. Each one of you have helped me to succeed academically and develop spiritually. And the class of 2021 right here is the result of all your hard work. Thank you so much for all that you have done for us. And now, my fellow classmates, we all first met at Building the Pride in the summer of 2017. We were all babies at that point, 14-year-olds wondering how we can adapt and survive high school. Literally, it's a scary world. Now look at us. We are here, wearing our caps and gowns, moving on to our next chapter of our lives into different schools and different paths. Thank you for the amazing 4 years. Thank you for making this high school experience the best one. Thank you personally for making me feel like myself. We have all faced so many challenges, good and bad, during these years. And I know we can and will support each other in the near future. God has blessed us with so many talents and so many people in our lives. Let us use them for the greater good. Growing up in a Vietnamese community, I heard this proverb quote. It means, if you're persistent enough, you can make needles out of metal bars. Keep dreaming, keep pushing, and never give up on yourself and your self-worth. As Mrs. Calabrese always says, Viva Cristo Rey. Signing off, Ginger Binge.
I now have the pleasure of introducing Nefertiti Dorantes, our second graduation speaker. Nefertiti is a creative student, both in and out of the classroom. She is a dedicated learner and a leader amongst her peers, having been on student council and in National Honor Society. Nefertiti was involved in theater, cross country, tennis, and basketball. Nefertiti will continue her Jesuit education next fall at Boston College. Please welcome Nefertiti Dorantes.
I'm short, hold on. Okay. All right, okay. Good evening, fellow graduates, and all guests from the board, Mr. Beck, and everyone else here and away. I mean, good afternoon, sorry about that. I wrote this expecting to be reading this at 7 p.m., but you know, it really wouldn't be Cristo Rey Jesuit if there weren't any last minute changes. So that's on me. My bad, I should have been better prepared. Having to write this in less than 3 to 5 business days, I should have charged an expedited shipping fee. Then again, I'm a master procrastinator. So this is a piece of cake. As many of you guys are, you understand. All of those races against the clock have prepared me for this very moment. I present to you speech brought to you by Commoner's Coffee, AKA Instant Coffee. These 4 years have been a cinematic experience, to say the least. The director and screenwriters went a little bit overboard, but nothing seems as fitting as hurricanes, floods, a plant explosion, and a snowstorm that overwhelmed the grid. Oh, and a global pandemic that affected millions of people worldwide, just to be one of the few things we had to overcome during our high school journey. We also survived Mr. Ridden, Miss Nixon, Mr. Deke, Mr. Hernandez, and Mr. Dragnus' rigorous courses, just to name a few. But the most difficult things we had to overcome were our own individual struggles. Pick a struggle, guys. High school for every single one of us was different despite living through it side by side. Some of us went through the hardest moments in our lives, yet we continued to resiliently walk the halls and get the job done, whether we liked it or not. Some of us had a whole 2000s early coming of age movie, and we will forever hold these memories dear. Alas, every single one of you has been a vital part of my own story. Every encounter I've made with each one of you has made me who I am today. I put up a wall almost 6 years ago, and I didn't want to let anyone climb it, punch it, kick it, pull it, twist it, bop it. I became quite defensive and refused to form any deep-rooted bonds with anyone, especially God. So learning that my parents wanted me to go to a Catholic private school made the matter worse. The summer leading up to building the Pride was filled with, do I have to go? Public school's free. Don't waste your money. Buy me a car instead. Despite my pleas, I woke up, put on my Hufflepuff-looking uniform, and tried to pretend I was going to Hogwarts instead. The second day of BTP, I saw this shy kid just sitting there on the bleachers on a Tuesday morning. I couldn't resist forcing someone out of their shell, so I went. I read their name on their handy-dandy name tag on their vest and hit them with their full government name. I claimed my first victim. That was the start of my first friendship here at CRJ. After such a successful morning, we met our Lido leader, James. Someone better give that man a raise. He inspired me to become a Lido leader myself, my junior and senior year, after his energy and personality convinced me that Cristo Rey Jesuit wasn't that bad thing. Aside from that, I joined several clubs and teams in attempt to find something to keep up with my time. Here I formed families, my tennis team, the theater kids, the basketball girls, the student council, my cross-country team, commonly mistaken for the track team. They even put our picture in the yearbook on their page, but it's okay. I'll forgive you guys. At first, it was just to avoid dealing with my own inner demons by keeping myself occupied. Before I knew it, I was the one taking down my own wall, brick by brick. I let those people in willingly, and I'll never regret it. I met the most loyal and amazing people that I share so many wonderful memories with. I made friendships that I hope will outlive Queen Elizabeth herself. But the most unexpected bond I've made was with God. I didn't grow up in a religious household. I knew about the big guy upstairs, and church was mandatory every Sunday, but that was about it. After extensive Socratics in theology, the retreats the school put us through, and the people in my life that already had formed their relationship with God, I started to cultivate my own. I still have much to work on, but that's okay. Everything's fine. I'm still growing, just like every single one of you. As Ms. Decker's last graduating class, I really hope she's looking upon us happy, especially for my boys who didn't even learn algebra before entering geometry, the audacity. She cared so much about us, that I truly believe she put her heart and soul into teaching us every day. Yet, we didn't know her own struggles. Likewise, I didn't know the kind of things you guys had to go through, especially my girls. At Kairos, I was able to see such a vulnerable side of many of you. I didn't have half the guts to stand up and say it there and then, but just know, me too. I've gone through my fair share of trauma, but you're all strong to be able to say it and continue to spread joy to those around you. Don't think I forgot about our number one supporters, the people who raised us. Thank you. We couldn't have done it without you guys. Thank you for putting up with us, but not only that, but also for pushing us to succeed. Whether they're here physically or spiritually, we would like to thank you for the support, your best intentions, your guidance, and for understanding that for some of us, this was a very rocky road. And I don't mean the ice cream flavor. I want to thank you all for the time and involvement in our lives. Part of the journey is the end. So before I go, I just want to say to you all, be better than you were yesterday. Be the best you can be at whatever you do. I truly am looking forward to seeing what you all become, to see you guys further grow into men and women for others. Thank you for coming to my TED Talk. Lady Bree, signing out.
Great, great.
The Cristo Rey Jesuit Presidential Medals of Excellence, cast with the seal of the president of the school, were created to recognize excellence in five joint areas: academics and intellect, faith and morals, service and social justice, industry and innovation, and vision and leadership. These five awards were named after founding friends of Cristo Rey Jesuit, who believed that no child should be denied a college prep education. The A.R. Tony Sanchez, Jr. and Tony Sanchez Presidential Medal of Excellence for Academics and Intellect is awarded to a graduating senior who exemplifies the graduate at graduation intellectually distinguished value. This student has a strong intellectual curiosity and has demonstrated a mastery of thinking, reasoning, and cognitive skills and habits. He or she is a lifelong learner who savors the rich opportunities that the world provides and engages others and the world in the spirit of dialogue and inquiry. The 2021 medal is awarded to Michaela Jernslatan. The Ray G. White Presidential Medal of Excellence for Faith and Morals is awarded to a graduating senior who exemplifies the graduate at graduation religious value. This student has a sincere and deep sense of God's presence and love in his or her life and demonstrates a personal and public commitment to his or her faith. He or she is humbly models himself or herself in the image and likeness of Jesus Christ, closely follows the teachings of the church, and provides others with an example of discipleship and citizenship. The 2021 medal is awarded to Jose Nerio. The Archbishop Joseph A. Fiorenza Presidential Medal of Excellence for Service and Social Justice is awarded to a graduating senior who exemplifies the graduate at graduation committed to doing justice value. This student believes in the dignity and equality of all people and is keenly aware of injustice and prejudice. As a leader and a role model, he or she is inspired and fueled by the desire to serve others, especially those who are marginalized or suffering, and is committed to leaving the world better than he or she found it through the promotion of social changes and the basic human rights of all peoples. The 2021 medal is awarded to Yan Romans. The John and Charlene O'Shea Presidential Medal of Excellence for Innovation and Industry is awarded to a graduating senior who exemplifies the graduate at graduation work experienced value. This student demonstrates a devotion to hard work, initiative, and innovation in the workplace, and a commitment to integrity and high ethical standards. As a future leader, he or she recognizes the dignity of work, its integration, its integral connection to justice, and the choices he or she has to create a better society. The 2021 medal is awarded to Kimberly Andres Rivera. The Bob Dunn Presidential Medal of Excellence for Vision and Leadership is awarded to a graduating senior who exemplifies the servant leader's ability to articulate a goal, inspire excitement for it, call upon others to support it, and empower all involved to achieve it. He or she has an infectious optimism and outlook, is not afraid to take bold steps in pursuit of the higher good, recognizes that with rights comes responsibilities, and ultimately puts the mission above all else. The 2021 medal is awarded to Ariana Diaz. The next two presidential awards celebrate the commitment of our Jesuit education and values. The Blessed Miguel Presidential Medal of Excellence for the Jesuit Graduate at Graduation Values is awarded to a graduating senior who embodies all of the graduate at graduation characteristics. This student is committed to justice, intellectually competent, loving, work experienced, open to growth, and religious, with an understanding of the overarching Jesuit mission of being a man or woman for others. The recipient of the Blessed Miguel Pro Presidential Medal of Excellence for the Jesuit graduation and graduation values is awarded to Justice Osandu. Father T.J. Martinez believed so deeply in the Jesuit teachings. In particular, one of his favorite sayings was this one by St. Ignatius of Loyola, "Go forth and set the world on fire." This award is presented to, this award is presented to the senior who embodies the spirit of Father T.J. Martinez and is someone who lights up a room, inspires others by their enthusiasm, faces challenges with energy and excitement, has a thirst for knowledge, and exhibits pride in their school and their community. Through their everyday actions, it is evident that this individual will go forth and set the world on fire. The recipient of the Father T.J. Martinez Ignatian Spirit Award is Carlos Ayon.
President Beck, as Director of Academics and Principal of Cristo Rey Jesuit, having examined the following candidates for graduation and affirming that they meet Cristo Rey Jesuit's graduation requirements and have received formation in the characteristics of the graduate at graduation, including being intellectually distinguished, religious, loving, committed to justice, open to growth and work experienced, and having completed the sequence of courses required by the Texas Catholic Conference Education Department. On behalf of the deans and faculty of the school, I have the pleasure to recommend that these students be granted a diploma from Cristo Rey Jesuit College Preparatory School of Houston.
Seniors, are you ready for this? Okay, when I call your name, you're going to come across the stage, or when your name is called, you're going to come across the stage, and I'm going to hand you your diploma. A photographer will take your picture then. Parents, I would just ask you to hold off your pictures until later. We'll have all the photography pictures will be available for you. On behalf of the Board of Trustees and as President of Cristo Rey Jesuit College Preparatory School of Houston, I now have the honor of conferring upon these seniors the recommended diplomas, and I name you graduates with all the rights and privileges therein.
We will now bestow diplomas to the Cristo Rey Jesuit Class of 2021. Christopher Manuel Amaro. Kimberly Andres Rivera, summa cum laude. Aaron Avalos. Rogelio Rafael Ayala, magna cum laude. Carlos Eduardo Ayón, summa cum laude. Brianna Lee Rose Barajas, magna cum laude. Benes Gustavo Basurto, the second, cum laude. Katia Bazan, summa cum laude. Roselyn Benitez, summa cum laude. Aviona Y. Brown. Emily Mori Bustamante. Camila Valentina Calderón. Yareli Córdoba Castañeda, cum laude. Jocelyn Alisa Castellan, magna cum laude. Suleyma Castorena. Jose Angel Chavero. Julissa Jade Coronado. Jonathan Covarrubias. Axel Yahir Crispin. Evelyn Victoria Davalos, cum laude. Cynthia Jacqueline de la Paz. Yasmin de la Rosa, summa cum laude. Alexandra del Valle, cum laude. Ariana Giselle Diaz Ramos, cum laude. Nevon Gwen Din, summa cum laude. Nefertiti Yael Dorantes, summa cum laude. Hannah Marie Edwards. Alondra Montserrat Escobedo, cum laude. Juliana Escobedo. Nathan Ignacio Esquivel. Belen Rafaela Evans, cum laude. Brisa Juliana Evans. Jaime Jose Garcia Coto. Magna cum laude. Daniel Mauricio Garza. Isabella Angelina Gillette, summa cum laude. Neida González Guerrero, summa cum laude. José Ezequiel Gorostieta. Nicolás Patricio Eduviges Granda. Alan Güell. Yamilet Guizar, summa cum laude. Sebastian Richard Gutierrez. Sergio Gutierrez. Ángel Alexander Enríquez. Anthony Hernández. Iván Alejandro Hernández Rocha. That's so pretty. Victoria Janet Hernández. Elijah Hinojosa, magna cum laude. Emily Jaime. Diamond Arlene Jasso. Pearl Jasso. Michaela Viola Wurzleben. Brianna Joseph. Ariana Maria Juarez. Magna cum laude. Clarissa Sine Lamar, summa cum laude. David Guadalupe Leal, cum laude. Sebastián Leal. Madeline Rosa Sofía Leija Casares, cum laude. Brianna Giselle Leija Murillo. Brandy E. Limas. Jessica Lisbeth Limas, summa cum laude. Stephanie Lisbeth Limas, summa cum laude. Estrella Linares, cum laude. Fernando Isael Loera. Araceli López, summa cum laude. Genesis Milena Mancia, magna cum laude. Angélica Márquez, summa cum laude. Adrian Martínez. Lisandro Martínez Mexquitic. Nathan Pete Martínez. Yeah. Savannah Isabella Martinez, magna cum laude. Melanie Carolina McDonald, cum laude. Ren Marie McLaughlin, magna cum laude. David Alexander Medrano. Cecilia Noemi Mejia, summa cum laude. Luis Melgar, cum laude. Josué Vicente Mexquiti. Manuel Miranda Casares, cum laude. Marina Montoya. Iliana Stephanie Morales. Kylie Victoria Morales. Valerie Jaslyn Morales. Isabel Neria. Jose Iran Cenerio, summa cum laude. Sergio Alfredo Nino. Jacob Ocampo. Jesús Osegueda. Frank Anthony Olivares, summa cum laude. Martina Oliver, magna cum laude. Adam Justin Orande. Giselle Orozco. José Alonso Ortega Niv. Justice Mark Osundu, summa cum laude. Leslie Maritza Osorio. Jeffrey Kibis Ozor, cum laude. Juliana Giselle Pasos Alvarez, magna cum laude. Jessica Peña, cum laude. Anthony Jesus Perez. Carlos Perez. Luis Fernando Pérez. Dejanae Grace Piquet. Brian Pineda. Leslie Prancarte. Cassandra Quiñones, summa cum laude. Salvador Ramirez Jr. Zachary Wesley Remonade. Ana Laura Renteria, summa cum laude. Anaí Reina. Yvonne Rivera Martínez, summa cum laude. Isabel Miranda Rodríguez. Kelly Rodríguez. Jan St. Conrad Romans II, summa cum laude. Joshua S. Romo. Alan Aurelio Rukova. Yeah. Ashley Saldierna. Jennifer Salgado, cum laude. Abraham Sanchez. Ana Maria Saucedo, cum laude. Andy Cecilia Silva. Cameron Smith. Julio Torres. Camila Mia Treviño, magna cum laude. Dominic Michael Tudon. Amy Nalia Ulloa. Elia Angelica Uribe. Daniel Valdez. Yahir Vázquez. Victoria Alexandria Velázquez. Yahaira Nayeli Velázquez, summa cum laude. Jocelyn Carson Yanez, summa cum laude. Would the class of 2021 please stand? You may now.
Do not throw their hat, Aileen. Tell them do not throw it yet. It's not time.
Please don't throw your hats. You may now move the tassel from the right side to the left.
Friends of the class of 2021, on this wonderful occasion, it is my great privilege to lead you into the final moment of your high school career, a moment in which together we will rightly give praise and honor to God for all that he has done for us. Through the ups and downs, God has been faithful, and Jesus Christ truly is the King of our lives. In a moment, we will sing together the words of our Cristo Rey Jesuit alma mater. And the song that we will sing is better described as a prayer, and it was written as such by a young man named John Guerra, S.J., a Jesuit novice who walked the halls of CRJ during your sophomore year. The words of the song he wrote were inspired by you, and they reflect the symbolism of our beautiful school crest and the power of the love of Christ in our lives. So please, graduates of 2021, and all family and friends gathered, I invite you to find the words of our alma mater on your programs, and let's sing together the song of our Cristo Rey Jesuit alma mater, which will be led by rising junior Tatiana Barron.
Long live Christ the King, whose light our lives here bring. Through the darkness to battles done, when love's radiance shines as the sun, with his power, his peace, and his word, his claim of hearts is heard. For life and love the lion roars, God's goodness more and more. Our work beneath the cross today to transform the world and lead the way to his kingdom where we will never part, wrapped in fire blazing from his heart. Que viva, que viva, viva Cristo Rey.
Ladies and gentlemen, I now have the privilege of presenting to you the graduates, Cristo Rey Jesuit, the senior class of 2021, and call the Cristo Rey Jesuit commencement ceremony to a close. Seniors, you may now throw your caps. Just make sure you catch them.